A question that keeps coming up over and over again is reference mixes and how to use them and why and when. So I'm gonna break that down for you again today. Now, what I do personally is probably a little different than most people. I know some guys that maybe listen to a mix other than what they're mixing once a week. And then me, I'm constantly listening to music while I'm working. I find it inspirational. Now, reference mixes aren't there to copy because you're not given the same information, so you can't really copy a mix you're listening to while you're working. But it should be for, like we talked about earlier, another ITL. It should be for inspiration, just to make sure that you're able to compete with what your contemporaries are doing. For example, if you wanted to be a track star and you decided, okay, I'm gonna run the 100 meter dash, you go out and practice and you get your time down to your best time is like 14 seconds. And you're like, well, damn, that's great. You go to your first track meet, Usain Bolt comes in at 9 seconds or less, and you're like, uh-oh, maybe I should have been checking to see what the competition's doing. And I use the word competition metaphorically, not, we don't really compete against each other. So let's go through a couple that I put together for you. A song I like a lot now that just gives me a good vibe and kind of helps me place my vocals, because a lot of times I won't place my vocals as loud as they should be. So this is We Found Love. The vocals out there by itself, it's a little easier to hear. Some of the delays on it I like. It sounds big without sounding reverby wet. So that'll kind of, if you listen to that all the way through and then you play your song and your vocal sounds like it's distant, you might want to take a look at your effects. And then, like we've said a million times, we like a little more mid-range, and that song is mixed flawlessly in terms of where the frequencies are in the vocal to make it sound modern and to make it cut through all those keyboards and all those drums. For all you guys that enjoy samples, I listen to this a lot because I just like the way the drums are placed, and I've actually pinched this kick and snare. So this is a dead mouse. Another thing that I like about this song is one of the things I noticed about the competition was some of you guys were afraid to drop some stuff out to create some ebb and flow. There was a long section in double mix competition. I don't know exactly how many bars, but it was long, probably 24, 32 bars. And a lot of you guys just let the drums go. There was no, you didn't mute anything. So I like the Susher song that Geta did. I like some of the dynamics, the way some of the mutes are done. I actually created my own little mix here, so there's a bad edit, but I'll play a piece of it so you'll know which one it is.
I am lost, I am vain, I will never be the same.
So a lot of information there about the vocals. Then when the drums come in, it's banging. Dylan knows how to do this stuff as good as anybody. But listen to that. That's a drier vocal, and then you can get a feel for the way the ebb and flow. You should know these things already. It's fun. It's fun to know these things about how other people construct the arrangement and when they drop stuff out. Sometimes I just want to make sure, because nowadays you're going to follow some hip hop stuff, and I love the mix on this Lil Wayne song.
So on my Libra scale, I'm weighing sins and forgiveness. What goes around comes around like a hula hoop. Karma is a bitch, well just make sure that bitch is beautiful.
One of the cool things about rap is the most important part of the track is the rap itself. So rappers have come out and the guys that mix rap, the most important thing that we can do in the mix process is make sure you hear the lyric. So it's a great way to figure out if you're if you've got your balance between the level of your vocal and the level of your track, even if you're doing a ballad. I like this song. If I'm doing an up tempo, I'll play this. I love the way Jason, the effects he's got on the vocal. It's like a little slight flange or something. He told me what he did, but I forgot what it was. But it's really cool.
When you rain on me, so tonight let's act it out and show you how it's gonna be. I'm gone.
Now that's Usher 2012. I'm not sure there's anybody that's doing delays as good as Jason. This is like a textbook in delays and effects. And then the drums come in, they're ballady. Great mix. And then probably the best mix I have in this group here is this one that I find inspirational. You can say bad about that one. So in review, like I said, everybody's different. Now, I'm always playing music when I'm working. Anytime I'm taking a break, I'm listening. And I don't always use all these songs. I did this to show you guys a little bit of variety. But sometimes I'll keep that many songs up, particularly if I'm starting a mix and I've got to do some technical things, hook something up. I'll just expand one or two of those and let it play. But for me, I'm pretty good at copying stuff, so if I listen to something else with the intent of copying it, I'm going to ruin the mix I'm working on, because it's probably not going to benefit by copying something. It needs to be itself. It's a whole unique set of sounds and concepts going on in the mix. But what you can make sure that you're doing is getting your levels, checking your compression, checking the way the vocal sits in the track. Is the snare banging enough? Is it not banging? Is it banging too much? The low end, is it right? Is it wrong? Those kind of concepts, you can really kind of help yourself save a little time. Now, if I take a break and come back fresh, I can hear a lot of these things easier than if I just keep working straight through for hours and hours. So sometimes you don't want to get up and stop. So playing something is a shortcut way of taking a break. Don't worry about the type of music, whether it's rock or hip hop or whatever, just things that inspire you, things that when you're driving down the road at 2 a.m. with the windows down and the radio blasting, those songs, put those in your reference folder, and then as you're working, make sure that you're getting those feelings and emotions. And those feelings and emotions are a function of the basic things like where you've got your vocal sitting, the way you've got your mid-range placed, the way you're using the low end for credibility, the way you've got your snare banged, whether you got the vocals dry or wet. All those kind of things can really help you. Okay? All right, guys.